This is a fishing trawler. It's used to gather large quantities of sea life forms for consumption by human populations. It's generally crewed by several humans. Since the beginning of human attempts to travel via waterways, being a crew of such craft was considered not safe. Since even before the written history, humans have captured and consumed waterborne life forms. But, in 2021, despite human advancements, it's the most dangerous job in the last three millenniums, and the most dangerous task currently undertaken recorded. Why did the risk of being a fisherman skyrocket in late 2020 and early 2021? Years of consumption lead to weaponization of nearly every major kind of fish. The entire world unraveled. Peace became a distant memory. Because if my time as the fisherman taught me one thing, it's that fishing never changes. Or so it's said. But now, fishing has changed. Gone are the days of fishing rods and the fishing nets. In the third decade of the third millennium, fishing has changed. Let me present you with a recording. This is a dummy fishing trawler that we have deposited on the Adriatic Sea at 12:31 local time. Watch as the situation unfolds. Your government is trying to protect you, and therefore keep you not informed about the situation. However, if you or your loved ones are a crew of such vessels, you should know how to keep yourself safe. Let's look at the evidence. What happened to these vessels? Government agents trying to cover it up might try to say the vessels were damaged due to bad weather conditions, material issues, human errors, navigation errors, and so on, but don't believe their lies. These vessels were attacked and sunk by the effort of local marine life, armed with high-grade weapons supplied to them by NGOs, with a being founded by an unknown enemy of the fishing industry and humanoid naval travel as a whole. This, in 2021, isn't surprising for anyone manning such vessels. Do not be tricked by the marine life forms and their simple appearance. They are known to rely on guerrilla tactics, engaging from a distance and quickly breaking contact before the enemy can respond, whittling down the enemy resistance and resources. Do you think that on the 12th of August 2000, Russian submarine K-141 Kursk sank in the Barents Sea? It was but one of many vessels lost to the fish menace. At the time of the destruction, the vessel was performing a secret mission, probably in an effort of the Russian Federation to curb the threat of the marine life forms in the Bering Sea region. However, they were not prepared that the fish would be at the time armed with a currently unknown make of a whale portable water-water anti-submarine torpedo, which hit the Kursk and destroyed it. It was not only another offensive by the fish, but also a scavenging effort as 24x SSN-19 P-700 Granite, and over 30 torpedoes capable of sinking major naval units fell into the hands of the marine life forms. The reactor core and fuel was also hijacked. And later an attempt of weaponization was made, thankfully averted by a joint UN raid on the Puerto Rico Trench in 2006, where fish nuclear program was destroyed. Ever since, all servicemen in the Navy and Air Force are doing everything they can to curb the fish threat, yet since October 2020 the fish and their new weaponry supplier can outsmart the world militaries daily. Let me bring a situation to mind that I'm sure you have experienced several times. While fishing on a fishing trawler, your craft is suddenly hit by several explosions that penetrate your hull and engine bay, leading to the destruction of the watercraft. Is this image familiar to you? It's a situation that happens daily to fishing crafts on every major waterway, and that's because the pre-October 2020 fishing trawlers have several mistakes in their technical design. Do you see it? The answer is obvious. The pre-2020 fishing trawler is a relatively slow, unarmored craft lacking an ability to defend itself from marine attacks, which is a recipe for disaster. Today, we will show you how to modify your fishing trailer to successfully fish in the lethal area with its fish-infested water. Let's begin with understanding the enemy methods, and therefore we can find solutions. Thankfully, all major navies have been dealing with the fish threat since October 28, 1962, where the combined Soviet-US navies have successfully driven back most of the marine hostiles from the American Caribbean coast. The continuous 58 years of war since has led to many technical advancements, most of them driven by the new methods used by the water enemy. The enemy didn't wait for either. Every child knows of the super animals such as the flying squirrel, electric eel, or Chinese water deer. But almost nobody knows about the recent biological advancements, to name a few. This is an average pre-1967 herring. This is an herring living in the year 2021. Do you see the difference? How about now? This is an Lockheed F-117 Nighthawk stealth fighter. This is an stealth herring. The enemy is using advanced design methods to actively avoid our detection and prevention systems by both minimizing his radar cross-section as well as by directing and reflected signal away from the detection device in an effort to terrorize civilian populations. This is how the world government want you to believe a great white shark looks like. However, this photo was heavily edited to look like this. Using state-of-the-art AI-driven technology, we are able to recover just how the photo looked before the photo manipulation techniques. As you can see, this great white shark is armed with at least one R-17SS-1D Scud Sea tactical ballistic missile, capable of engaging both naval and inland targets from as much as 600 kilometers away. He is also armed with unknown amount of dumbfire torpedoes, able to destroy ships at close distances. Swordfish have evolved to employ an armor-piercing fin-stabilized discarding sabot with an penetration fuse-activated high-gain-shaped charge, capable of penetrating up to 1,500 mm of rolled homogeneous armor. As of now, February 2021, it is yet to evolve to defeat reactive armors such as SLERA, self-limiting explosive reactive armor. Prior to 1968, flying fish were a small oceanic fish capable of short-term fight using its fins. Since 1969, the fish have become one of the most dangerous predators of both the ocean as well as the coast areas. Since 80s, the fish started to employ turboprop engines, and in the late 2010s, most flying fish are equipped with an lightweight jet engine, usually an PBS-TJ-100 turbojet engine, which allows them to achieve speeds above sound barrier and recorded altitudes up to 4.2 kilometers. Most fish are armed with two wing-mounted Hispano Suiza HS.404 20mm autocannons, capable of firing up 1,400 shots in a minute, and therefore are a major threat to low-flying aircraft and unarmored or undefended ships. Barnacles. Barnacles are often employed by the fish to gather intel on human naval craft's movements, both civilian and military. Barnacles stack to the underside of an craft and emit both RF localization pings and acoustic pings, allowing for easier target acquisition by the fish strike forces. It is of utmost importance that all barnacles are to be removed from the ship underside, as even one can guide a long-range acoustic torpedo straight to you from as much as 39 kilometers. As a fishing trawler crew, you are likely to be engaged by several low-effort methods employed by the fish, most of them allowing them to engage from a huge distance in a four-dimensional interpretation of space, leading to you never seeing the attacker. These methods include, but are not limited to, mine-laying, sabotage, and torpedo strikes. This is a VS-6215ST stern trawler, a 2016 82 meters long state-of-art fishing trawler. As a pre-October 2020 trawler, it's not fitting to the modern situation but will make an excellent base with some modifications. Like most pre-2020 fishing trawlers, VS-6215ST lacks any dedicated active or passive defense systems, but it has many features that allow the end user to quickly and with little effort upgrade it to be safe in 2021. The VS-6215ST is powered by a Wärtsilä 31 main engine 6000 kW at 750 revolutions per minute with low noise level according to Silent F class, which reduces the risk of enemy passive accosting guidance systems to work effectively. The craft is capable of reaching speeds of 16 knots, allowing for effective evasion of enemy projectiles. The craft comes stock with a civilian-grade advanced satellite radar, as well as a human light-range CCTV system, however, it lacks any other detection system. The hull thickness is not specified, but for the guide, we will estimate it as around 0.5 centimeters on average. This is an unmanned dummy fishing trawler of an unknown make, with vaguely similar characteristics to the VS-6215 recorded during a bait operation in the Black Sea region conducted by the Turkish Navy. Watch as the ship comes in contact with the magnetic minefield deployed by the marine life. The ship is promptly destroyed. This shows that a fishing trawler has to be able to passively detect enemy minefields from a safe distance. To do that, it would be an option to use the optical buds of the crew, however, human optical buds are known to be suboptimal in bad lighting and weather conditions. A wide-spectrum optical system such as a Vigi Observer Panoramic Gyro Stabilized Observation System is a recommended alternative. Several of these should be placed around the craft for optimal sighting range. A low-latency remote connection should be established with both satellites and coast-based station to provide a detailed view from both aerial and remote angles. Ship-based UAVs are also recommended, providing an additional potential early warning to the system. However, it is also a fact that even advanced optical systems cannot see through cover, such as the trash piles that the enemy fish often use to hide minefields. Leading to this, the trawler has to be equipped with both passive and active sonar systems, also covering 360 degrees of the craft, with preferable minus 180 degrees vertical coverage. This should allow the craft to safely detect and avoid minefields. However, as they are often mobile with the water body, it's recommended to destroy the mines if they are found. On the post-2020 trawlers, a dedicated 85mm plus hotwiser is turret-mounted for this purpose, but we can't justify modifying the hull to that extent. In that case, several 30mm AGS-17 or 40mm MK-19 automatic grenade launchers should be mounted around the hull, as they provide an excellent method of remote detonation of sea mines. Let's review the material we showed before, from the dummy at the Adriatic Sea. This craft was hit by an active acoustic or remotely controlled torpedo, as it was able to hide a turned-off craft center on, which is very unlikely for dumbfire. This means that the craft should be armed with at least one, preferably several, hard kill, soft kill, and passive systems to deal with the torpedoes, with a responsible for more than 80% of the thrallers lost since January 2020. The obvious first step is to connect the previously mounted active-passive sonar system to a high-performance computer able to live to calculate the threats and countermeasures in water. The next step should be an introduction to a turret-mounted water-water anti-torpedo torpedo systems, such as a Selsun Torq or Rafael Torbuster 4th generation defense system or Scutter 3th gen defense system. In this experiment we will be using a preparatory-made anti-torpedo torpedo 470mm Ni-47IT intercepting torpedo. Ni-47IT uses a state-of-the-art guidance system. The core of the guidance is the logic line of: the torpedo knows where it is at all times, relative to both the target and the host craft. It knows this because it knows where it isn't. By subtracting where it is from where it isn't, or where it isn't from where it is, whichever is greater, it obtains a difference or deviation. The guidance subsystem uses deviations to generate corrective commands to drive the torpedo from a position where it is to a position where it isn't, and arriving at a position where it wasn't, it now is. Consequently, the position where it is now the position that it wasn't, and it follows that the position that it was, is now the position that it isn't. The torpedo also knows where the target is at all times. It knows this because it knows where it isn't. By subtracting where it is from where it isn't, or where it isn't from where it is, whichever is greater, it obtains a difference or deviation. The guidance subsystem calculates deviations to generate a position where it will be from a position where it isn't, and arriving at a position where it wasn't, it now will be. Consequently, the position where it was in the position that it isn't, and it follows that the position that it will be, is now the position that it isn't. The torpedo guidance computer scenario works as follows. Because a variation and measurement have modified some of the information the torpedo has obtained, it is not sure just where it is. However, it is sure where it isn't within reason, and it knows where it was. It also knows where the target was and where it isn't. It now subtracts where it should be from where it wasn't, or vice versa, and by differentiating this from the algebraic sum of where it shouldn't be with also is an algebraic sum of where the target should be, and where it was, it can obtain the deviation and its variation, which is called a correction. As you can see, the sonar detection system has detected an enemy torpedo and deployed a counter torpedo torpedo with went on an interdiction course with it, destroying both. However, using this system solely, if the craft will be engaged by multiple torpedoes, the following rounds will successfully penetrate. This is not an acceptable situation. Therefore, as a massive majority of the enemy torpedoes are acoustic, a soft kill decoy torpedo is an excellent solution. US Navy has deployed an SLQ-25 Nixie Toad torpedo with great success at fooling the fish guidance systems, however for a largely immobile target with is a fishing trawler during fishing that solution is less than ideal. Therefore we have developed another preparatory torpedo that is a wider solution for this threat. Decoy torpedo 470mm Ni-47 DSRH, sonar, radar, heat, is a universal soft kill system designed to lead guided munitions using acoustics, radar, or IR tech away from the target craft. In this situation, four enemy torpedoes are fooled by the 47 decoy. The design allows to guide the torpedoes outside of an angle where they can engage the host ship, however, the torpedo may engage another target in proximity. Please, keep that in mind when deploying those countermeasures. If deemed necessary, a secondary ballistic hardkill system could be deployed. Weapon systems like the M167 VADS, Phalanx CIWS, or Kashtan CIWS could effectively stop a torpedo or a low-flying missile or an air threat before it destroyed the craft. It's recommended to apply such weapons if possible. However, we have decided not to do it in this experiment phase as we deemed it unnecessary. Additionally, a secondary softkill system should be deployed. An example being a ZARGANA submarine torpedo countermeasure system with ZOKA acoustic jammers and acoustic decoys. Additionally, a high-gain antenna should be mounted and an RF sniffer jammer should be operational at all times to hopefully disrupt enemy radio-controlled torpedoes and improvised weapons. But in case the system fails, or a munition can pass through the soft, hard-kill, decoy zone, the craft has to be able to withstand a hit to itself. Therefore, to withstand the rugged conditions of 2021, a fishing trawler should have his crucial elements covered with at least third-generation era armor such as OELIKT with a preferable higher level. Center of the craft, propellers, and engine room outside should be covered as they are the most likely and most important hit zones. Let's place our craft with all the aforementioned defense systems on the Irish Sea, just outside of Belfast. No naval-borne threat should be an issue for the craft at the minute. I was born on a Dublin street where the Lyle drums did beat.
with this chorus. Come on, shipwreck and tans, come out and fight.
The lesson learned: tunnel vision. We have paid so much attention to counter the unyielding subsurface threat of the fish that we have forgotten about the island-dwelling humanoid species, and therefore we have not adequately prepared for an air attack. This is a crucial tactical error that you should not repeat. Stay safe. Stay dry. Eat fish, they are the enemy.